I am Dr. Madhusudanan, Professor in the Department of Kaya Chikitsa, PNPS Ayurveda Medical College, Kanyangad. Today, we will discuss about how to approach Kaya Chikitsa practical examination. The purpose of examination is where you will give a practical and verbal response to your topic. The preparation includes self-preparation, bedside exam preparation, preparation for viva. Self-preparation, physically we have to prepare for examination. That is, follow the COVID-19 protocol, like using sanitizer, wearing mask, gloves, face shield, etc. Maintain personal hygiene. Strictly you have to follow the hygiene, that is clean nail, hair, teeth, etc. and well dressed. Mentally, we have to prepare for examination, that is, you should be cool, energetic, confident, and other preparations, have proper breakfast and lunch, carry hall ticket while appearing for examination, carry university ID card, practical record, and careful that you have to write the exam date in the front page of record book. All the necessary instruments should be kept ready with you, and you should know the usage of all those instruments. Before the examination, study hall syllabus, should know about the mark distribution. The Kaya Chikitsa examination, practical examination, carry 100 marks. For that, 50 marks for practical and 50 marks for viva. The practical 50 marks include daily case record cases, that carries 20 marks. Patient examination, long case 20 marks, short case 10 marks. And for viva, 25 marks for first part and 25 marks for second part, so totally 50 marks. If the practical exam was little bit tough, then you are having one more chance. If you are excellent in your viva, you can score good marks. How to get maximum confidence? Get a broad idea about your subject, good at the basics of a subject, that is, you must know about Kaya Chikitsa first part thoroughly, then 100% sure that you can score good marks in Kaya Chikitsa examination. Good preparation, that will increase your confidence. Clearly hear the questions from the examiner, then only you have to answer. Always have faith in yourself. Bedside examination, keep good relation with the patient. Ask the permission from patient before examining him or her. Ask the history properly. And ask sometimes leading questions. That is, whether the area is painful, no pain in this area, or this is not painful, no. Like that you have to ask. Next is case presentation. First point is patient identification data. Name, age, sex, religion, marital status, occupation, education, economical status, address, OP number, IP number, etc. should be collected properly, and find any relation with the present disease. Presenting complaint with duration, you have to write since how many days, or since how many months, or since how many years the patient is having this symptom. History of present complaint, that must include onset, site of pain, nature of pain, aggravating factor and relieving factor. History of previous illness, illness which is related to this disease you have to trace. Then about the history, operation history and fall and trauma, etc. you have to mention here. Next is personal history, about appetite, You must write either good or impaired, and diet, veg, non-veg or mixed. Bowel, the duration, since how many times per day the patient is passing stool, and which is regular or irregular. Then also you have to ask, if the patient is having constipation, you have to ask since how many days the patient is having constipation. If it is after the occurrence of this disease, then you can write along with the disease the patient is having vibandham or constipation. Sometimes the patient will have habituated constipation, so that you have to ask properly. Maturation, the duration, how many times in the night the patient will pass the urine, and how many times in the morning the patient will pass urine, and which is regular or irregular. Sleep also you have to write, that is sound sleep or disturbed sleep. Allergy, history of allergy you have to trace, and ask the patient about the history, whether she or he is having any history of allergy, that you have to mention here. Habit, excessive intake of coffee or tea, etc., etc., you have to collect, and how duration and quantity also you have to mention here. Addictions, alcoholic or smoking, how many quantity of alcohol the patient is consuming, and the time, how many the duration the patient is taking that type of habit addictions. So all the things you have to collect properly. Family history, anyone in his family having similar complaint, that you have to mention here. So next is general examination. Among that, first point is pulse rate. The method is very, very important, and the presentation also important. The pulse rate presentation includes rate, rhythm, volume, character, etc. And heart rate and respiratory rate, this is also, the method is very, very important. How will you see the heart rate and respiratory rate? These are the things the examiner will watch you. And about blood pressure and tying of cuff, how will you see, how will you tie the cuff, and which are the method you are using? Always use first palpatory method, and then only you have to go for auscultatory method. And temperature, the area you must know, especially the below the tongue, axilla, rectal area, we will see the temperature. And wiping of the thermometer also important, how will you wipe the thermometer. And also this is called as pickle, that is pallor, icterus, cyanosis, clubbing, lymphadenopathy and edema. So pallor, the area is palpable conjunctiva, we will see the pallor. Icterus is bulbar conjunctiva. Cyanosis, it is of three types: central cyanosis, peripheral cyanosis and mixed cyanosis. And clubbing, you must know about the that is Shamroth sign. And lymphadenopathy, the area you must know: cervical, axillary and inguinal region. And edema, that is especially general edema, generalized edema or peripheral edema, localized edema, and pitting edema or non-pitting edema. And next is Ashtasthana Parisha, that is according to the classical science, you have to see the Nadi, Mutram, Malam, Jihwa, Shabda, Sparsha, Drik, Akriti. Physical examination includes Jatrurdham, Madhyamam and Shagha, and you have to see any findings, any problem the patient is having, you must write that problem here. Next is systemic examination. First is locomotor system. The method is inspection, palpation and movements. So first you have to compare both side. If the patient is having pain in the knee joints, you have to compare both the knee joints. And if the presentation, if you are writing in the case sheet, you have to write the area, right or left. And in the inspection, swelling, redness, deformity, muscle wasting, you have to write. And palpation, temperature, tenderness, joint crepitus, effusion. And if the patient is not having any symptom related to locomotor system, then you can write no swelling, redness, deformity, muscle wasting, or no temperature, tenderness, joint crepitus or effusion. And if the patient is having low back pain, the test like SLR test, you have to go for SLR test, active and passive, Brackard sign, Lessige sign, etc. Next is central nervous system examination. First point is higher mental function. Here you have to see consciousness, orientation, memory, speech, etc. And next you have to go for cranial nerve examination. And next is motor functions. Here strength of muscle, bulk of muscle, tone of muscle and reflex you have to see. And under reflex, while doing the reflex, you have to go for the reinforcement and ask the patient to pull the hands and ask the patient to clench the teeth, etc. And mainly the reflex such as superficial reflex, deep tendon reflex and visceral reflex you have to follow and write the gradings if it is 0, 1, 2, etc. And next is sensory system examination. Here you have to see touch sensation, pain sensation and temperature, etc. And next you have to go for the gait assessment. And if it is normal, central nervous system examination is normal, you have to write intact. Next is gastrointestinal tract examination. First is inspection that will includes umbilicus, visible pulsation, distinction of abdomen, etc. And palpation, ask the patient lie on back, shoulder raised slightly and leg should be flexed to relax the abdomen. And ask the patient to keep mouth open and breathe quickly and deeply. And the patient head should turn opposite to the examiner. So these are the things you have to follow while doing the palpation. And percussion, the purpose of percussion in GAT is for confirming the enlarged organ. And auscultation, through auscultation you can see the peristaltic movements. Normally, if it is normal GAT exam examination, then you have to write no tenderness, no organomegaly, etc. Next is cardiovascular system examination. Here, first is inspection. Through inspection, you have to see size and shape of chest, palpation, apex beat, pulsation of abnormal sides, thrills, carotid artery pulsation, etc. And percussion, you can see the determination of cardiac border. And auscultation, you have to see the aortic area, pulmonary area, mitral area and tricuspid area. And if it is no findings are available here, then you can write S1, S2 heard and there is no murmur. Next is respiratory system examination. Here first is inspection. Here you have to see size and shape of chest, respiratory movements, position of apical thrust, scar marks, chest movements, types of breathing, etc. And in palpation, you have to see the swelling, apical thrust, position of trachea, chest movements, vocal fremitus, etc. And under percussion, it should be done in the ladder pattern to confirm the effusion. If it is pleural effusion, there may be dull sound, and if there is pneumonia, then there may be hyperresonant sounds. And also the auscultatory area like supraclavicular, supramammary, infraclavicular, upper axillary, lower axillary, suprascapular, interscapular and infrascapular. These are the main auscultatory area under respiratory system examination. And breath sounds, you have to see whether it is vesicular sound or bronchial sound. And added sound also you have to write, that is ronchi, crepitus or pleural rub. And if the everything is normal, then you have to write no ronchi, crepitus, normal vesicular breath sound heard. Under investigation, you have to write appropriate investigation in this particular disease with its normal value. Dashavidha Parisha, according to the classical science, Dushyam, Desham, Balam, Kalam, Analam, Prakritim, Vayaha, Sattvam, Satyam, Aharam. These are the examination you have to follow under Dashavidha Parisha. Vikriti Parisha includes Doshavastha, whether it is Samavastha or Niramavastha. That is according to the classical science, वायु सामयुबंधो अग्निशात तंत्रांध्र कूजनेहि लाइक दैट यू हैव टू असेस द सामावस्था निरामावस्था एंड शोधस ऑल्सो विच इज इन्वॉल्व्ड शोधस इन दिस डिजीज दैट यू हैव टू मेंशन हियर एंड रोगमार्गम वेदर इट इज बाह्य मर्मास्थि संधि एंड मध्यम यू हैव टू राइट हियर एंड निधानम वाट इज एक्साक्ट निधान इन दैट पर्टिकुलर डिजीज यू हैव टू राइट हियर पूर्वरूपम वाट पूर्वरूप द पेशेंट हैड दैट इज ऑल्सो यू हैव टू राइट एंड रूपम what are the lakshana presently that you have to write here and upashayam that is which are the upashaya factor the patient is having and samprapti also you have to write and vyavachedakandana that is disease closely related to the present disease don't write unnecessary things always which is a closely related disease that you have to mention here and while doing the differential diagnosis you have to write the why it is included and why it is excluded and next is roga nirnayam which is the diagnosis of disease and which is the disease here and you have to write the doshanubandham also if it is gridrasi and you have to write vadajam or vadakaphajam like that you have to write and upadravam if the patient is having any upadrava like shotham etc you have to mention here and arishta lakshana if the patient is having arishta lakshana shows arishta lakshana then you can write here and sadhya sadhyata based on all the criteria above said criteria you can mention you can write the sadhya sadhyata next is treatments first one is chikitsa sutra you must know the chikitsa sutra of that particular disease and next about the shamana medicines that is loka you must know that is if it is sahajradi kashaya you are writing sahajradi kashayam you must know the kashaya yoga sahajram saradaru sadagaram kodambasi tailam mishidam like that and ingredients also you should know the ingredients which are the ingredients in that particular yogam and dose that is according to the panchavida kashaya kalpana you have to know the what is a kashaya dose of kashayam what is a dose of churnam etc you must know and prashaya dravya that is according to the yoga wise acharya explains different prashepaka dravyam so that you must know about the prashepa dravyam or that particular yoga you have written and anupanam and what is the anupana exact anupana that is explained under this particular yogam and aushadha sevana kalam that is yunjad ananam annado like that sloka you must remember that sloka and according to that you have to write the aushadha sevana kalam and phalashuddhi also so if you are writing a yoga in the phalashuddhi that roga should be there in the phalashuddhi then only that will be 100% complete next is about the shodhana chikitsa so before selecting the shodhana chikitsa you have to consider dosha which is the increased dosha here and what is a rogi bala and roga bala and dosha avastha which is a samavastha or niramavastha and according to the asana root yadasanam yathabalam that is nearest root you have to decide the shodhana chikitsa and about rasayana chikitsa especially the vyadihara rasayana you must write here before entering for vaiva stop studying 5 minutes before vaiva and greet the examiner that good morning sir good morning ma'am sir ma'am thank you sorry sir etc and sit properly with the permission of examiner maintain good eye contact with the examiner be cautious before uttering a word create positive environment around you try to answer the question proper confidently discuss the previous asked questions with your friends tell don't know if you don't know the answer don't stick to previous asked questions you must know about the chikitsa sutra aushadha yogam agraushadhi and rasayana vajikaranam and modern topics I wish all the very best for your coming practical examinations thank you